The following is a presentation of ABC's Wide World of Sports, home of the World and U.S. Figure Skating Championships.
The challengers have come to Spokane, Washington, seeking victory in the initial event in the Grand Prix of Figure Skating. Alexei Yagudin hasn't tasted defeat in over a year. Last season, the Russian captured an Olympic gold medal, a world championship, and a Grand Prix title. Today, Yagudin seeks his third Skate America crown against a revitalized Michael Weiss. The 26-year-old father of two continues to regain the form that led him to two U.S. titles and two world bronze medals. Yagudin, Weiss, and an international field skate for gold in the men's championship at Smart One Skate America next on ABC Sports.
Spokane, here in the eastern part of the state of Washington, home to one of the largest waterfalls in any city in North America, as we bring you back inside the Spokane Arena for the first stop in the Grand Prix of Figure Skating. Welcome back, everybody, to our continuing coverage of the 2002 Smart Ones Skate America. The men getting set to skate for the gold medal. Final group on the ice warming up, including the reigning Olympic champion from Russia and the four-time world champ, Alexei Yagudin. He has the lead after the short program for the men. We check the standings right now. Yagudin on top, then a surprise. The teenager from France, Brian Joubert, in second, ahead of Alexander Abt of Russia. Two Americans, Michael Weiss and Matt Savoy, in fifth and in sixth place. And hi again, everybody. I'm Terry Gannon. Welcome back to Spokane. The first event in the Grand Prix of Figure Skating. Six events over the course of 6 weeks. We'll be all over the world. Plenty of frequent flyer miles for us. The men about to skate for the gold medal. Three golds already earned. Just the men left right now. And of course, this is our first look at the new interim judging system put in place by the ISU. So we'll talk about the early reviews, talk more about that as the afternoon rolls on. I turn right now to the two-time Olympic gold medalist, Mr. Dick Button. And Dick, let's talk about Alexei Yagudin. He's here, he's got the lead, he's skating well, but he's also dealing with an ailment. He's got a stress fracture in his hip. So far, he's held up.
Well, you know, the whole group is an interesting group of skaters. I mean, they represent Russia, France, the United States, China. It's a very exciting group. But we're going to have to quickly be able to count and see which of these skaters are able to complete all the necessary quadruple jumps that they have planned. But we're also going to have to watch a little bit longer to see whether these skaters will get into the role, inhabit the role that they are electing to do. And that's the theatrical side of skating, and that's what makes it interesting and different. Now, Alexei Yagudin, if his hip doesn't desert him, he'll be easy to count the quads. He'll do them with his hand tied behind his back. You'll also easily to see the role, the drama in his. There's drama in them thar toe picks. Now, during the short program, I got all tied up analyzing France's Brian Joubert, criticizing his last spin combination. And then he went off and pulled off a standing ovation. No one cared one hoot if his spin was mediocre. It was the French drama they liked. And then there's Alexander Abt, also from Russia. He's a little more problematical. His jumps can come or they can go. He can be wildly dramatic and they can suddenly lose steam. What will he do today? I haven't got the foggiest notion. Michael Weiss, on the other hand, is the ultimate competitive journeyman. He fights constantly and competes all winter long. When he does skate well, you sigh in relief and sit back and enjoy him.
As we've said, there is a new judging system in place. There are the judges right there. There are 10 of them. But as we check out the rules this year, an expanded panel of up to 14. 10 here. A computer randomly picks a selection of 5 to 9 judges. Here it's 7. Marks displayed anonymously in ascending order, and the placements also displayed anonymously in ascending order from only the judges that count. No one knows who they are.
Competitor representing Russia, Alexander Abt.
To get the men's free skate underway, here is the 26-year-old from Moscow, Alexander Abt, the ultimate wild card. One event, he'll come in eighth, look horrible. The next one, he'll stand on the podium. So far, he's looked pretty good here. He is in third place after the short program.
Bolero by Maurice Ravel. Anybody in skating that chooses Bolero after Tor Blundin is taking a chance. Here, a quad, toe, triple toe. Gorgeous. You could see him leaning right out of the circle. The legs split on the landing. The edges split in different directions. And that was the end of that one.
And a hard fall.
Another fall.
Skate for the men, by the way, 4.5 minutes long and worth 2/3 of the overall score.
Beautiful camel position. I might tell you that 50 years ago we had to skate 5 minutes in time.
When real men skated.
And that could bore the pants off you. I think a little bit of a criss on the legs and on the edge that he landed, which may hurt it in slow motion.
Soviet era until recently. Start of this season, actually, just switched coaches to Sasha Zhulin, the 93 World Ice Dance champ. And Dick, it seems like it's been since the Soviet era that people were talking about what potential, what great potential this guy has.
It's being able to perform it regularly, steadily, and under pressure. Anybody can do it on the practice ice. The question is, how do they do it when they get under the lights and in front of the judges? Watch him step out of this combination spin and move into this combination. Whoa, he just flopped it right off. He had originally planned a wonderful series of jumps there in that spin, a flying camel, a jump over, and a backspin, and there wasn't the energy to carry it out.
Well, one of the reasons he hasn't reached the potential over the years, a series of injuries, a hip, a knee, a quad. Actually, it kept him in the hospital for 6 months, but Alexander Apt in third after the short program, his effort here in the free skate.
Well, after performing a great quadruple toe in the first moment of the program, he did this one here, and watch what happens as he steps, turns, and right there, leaning way out of the circle, way to behind him. The landing leg just shoots right out, both
both feet just fly apart, and that's the end of it. That always hurts me to see that.
Alexander Abt for technical marks.
There's his coach, Sasha Julin. Now remember, the marks, there are 10 judges, but only 7 will count. 5.4 to 5.7 listed in ascending order, but you don't know whose marks are from whom.
Well, those technical merit marks were very high. The presentation marks a little bit higher, as they should be, but those were high technical marks, I'll tell you that right now.
Now the placements that actually count, the 7 judges whose marks count, they don't know who they are, but Alexander Abt, first place across the board so far. Still to skate here in Spokane, Alexei Yagudin, whose hip injury has held up so far. But up next, it's Michael Weiss, the 2-time U.S. champ, 2-time world bronze medalist with his new set of Freedom Blades. He'll take the ice next. Back here in Spokane, welcome back to Smart One Skate America. The men's free skate continues, and getting set to skate, Michael Weiss, the 2-time U.S. champion who's had a couple of years of injuries and downtimes. Last year, though, at the end of the season, really had a resurgence. He finished 6th at the World Championships. Here he is in 5th after the short. With all that he has accomplished, it is hard to believe that he has never won a senior Grand Prix event.
He's always struggled with his quadruple jumps. Here's the quadruple Lutz that he will try again. It's been an ongoing problem, one that he has not yet licked. Incidentally, this program is an adaptation of his Malaguena short program from last year. Double toe instead of a triple. I think I miscalled that. Looks like it was a triple and not a double. Blink and an extra revolution goes right by you.
Quit blinking. Michael, of course, married and the father of 2. Annie Mae is now 4 years old. Christopher Michael is 2 years old. He came in 7th at the Olympics in Salt Lake City and skated very well. The World Championships then as well, and came in 6th.
Now on this triple axle, triple toe combination, watch the takeoff edge. See if he rises up straight, double and triple. Played it safe. That became a double loop, if I'm not blinking. Anytime that there are major mistakes like this, the fall and doubling instead of tripling jumps is clearly bound to affect the judges, and it will hurt him tremendously. He's in 5th place coming in after the short program. It's certainly not going to help him move up, and he'd better watch that it doesn't lower him. Calls that Mike Pike into a triple flip. That was neat and easy and very clean. That was a double axel, but did you see him skid off the edge and lean back? That's been the problem with his axels all these years. He doesn't step up into the jump and lean forward. You can't jump up a flight of steps leaning backwards.
Saw a little move there on the Freedom Blades, as he calls them.
And down on the triple Lutz. Combination spin, camel sit spin, back sit spin, and a cross foot. Back scratch, hands over the head, rather.
Just was not his day.
No, you know, that's, there's so many skaters that just are inconsistent from performance in and performance. It's one thing to go through life and occasionally make a mistake. I think we see that with Michelle Kwan, and we've certainly seen it with and Patrice McDonough. You can't do it real frequently.
Michael Weiss, the 26-year-old from Fairfax, Virginia, come back, check his marks. Coming up next, then another American, Matt Savoy, who finished sixth here last year, but this year he just may have his quad with him.
And now for Matthew Savoy.
So far, it's Alexander Abt and Michael Weiss, the top two here in the men's free skate, but here's another American. The 22-year-old from Peoria, Illinois, Matt Savoy, currently in sixth place after the short.
Combination up to the very last second when he couldn't hold that edge, and that was a hand down. Now, if he's going to do it, this will be his quadruple toe. No, he elects to do a double axel instead.
Michael Weiss, by the way, received marks ranging from 4.6 up to 5.6, and he is in second place overall. Well, Matt Savoy had a great year back in 2000-2001 in the Grand Prix. He made it to the Grand Prix final where he captured the bronze medal. Had some injuries last year and faltered a little bit trying to work his way back. Won that bronze medal at the U.S. Nationals in 2001.
And that was a double instead of a triple salchow. A series of moves in the field, things designated by the skating associations to test different positions and turns and edges.
Those like you, Mr. Button, who took a full course load in college while skating, recently graduated from Bradley University.
I respect him for that, considering the demands of skating today.
And he may go to law school. Thank you.
He always has some interesting aspects to his jumps. Enters them differently, changes them around. Look at this. Triple flip. Spin combination, camel, half foot sit with a straight leg, a back camel. Now watch him drop into a back sit, turn it into a cannonball, pull it up into the air, catch, foot, back spin, hands over the head. What more do you want in that spin? The kitchen sink?
Hey, listen to this crowd. Many of them on their feet. Matt Savoy. First trip last year to the World Championships on the senior level, and he came in 12th. But he was injured much of last year. He had a groin injury, some other problems, and right now, great start to this year.
Now, on this combination early in the program, he first did this triple axel. Now, watch him step up into the air, cross the legs, and land. And beautiful thing at this point, but at this double, or this toe loop right here, he just wasn't able to stay straight in the air, curved too far to the end, and a hand went down.
It may be tough to make a run at Alexander Abt, who leads, because Abt was in third after the short program, but Michael Weiss is in second. We'll see if he can catch him. Technical merit, 5.3 to 5.6.
And very nice. Even though he put a hand down and had a few little problems here and there, those were really quite high and apparently good. And the presentation marks from 5.4 to 5.6 are also very nice.
At the moment, and that puts him from the United States
in second place. At this point.
Every one of the judges with the number two up there. So Matt Savoy right behind Alexander Abt and ahead of Michael Weiss at this point. When we come back, the man who's got a chance to win his first senior Grand Prix medal, and it could be gold, Brian Joubert, the 18-year-old, is out there next after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
And now, Christy Yamaguchi.
Now you can feel like this and eat pizza. Smart Ones Pizza. Delicious personal pizzas with all your favorite toppings. When you're smart, it shows.
This Wide World of Sports update brought to you by SpeedPass, today's way to pay at Exxon and Mobil retailers.
This Exxon Mobil SpeedPass update. Hopefully you were with us last Sunday to watch history being made in the ladies' free skate. Yukari Nakano of Japan, a triple axel, only the third lady ever to do it. Tanya Harding has done it. Midori Ito did it. She was the last in international competition in 92. But then, a few skaters later, Ludmila Niladina from Russia, she completes the triple axel, two of those in one free skate. Amazing. So far, it's Alexander Abt who has the lead over Matt Savoy and Michael Weiss here in the men's free skate. Terry Gannon, Dick Button along with you. As Brian Joubert takes the ice, who would have imagined that Brian Joubert, 18 years of age, and a guy who is really inexperienced, would be in second, right behind Alexei Yagudin after the short program, but that's where he is.
Landing. Did you see the flow out? Not a change in the edge on the landing, just a beautiful, clean, flowing edge. That's just delightful to see. It's a triple axle, triple toe. Double toe.
Post-Olympic year, we always begin to see the next generation emerge, and he certainly is one of those. In 1 year, Dick, he went from 14th at the French Nationals to 14th at the Olympics.
You know, he has a great deal of flair. In the short program, we saw him bring the house to its feet, even while I was criticizing one of his spin combinations. Nobody cared about the spin combination. They just wanted to see that nice French flair. Kind of a fallout. Going back to his spins, these positions not quite low enough. Nice tension in his skating. You can feel the strength that he puts into these edges. Gets nice height in those. Anytime you see the skater complete the revolution in the air and then break open and land as a second move, you know it's been beautifully done.
He went to the European Championships for the first time last year and captured the bronze medal. He said it was amazing. Last year I was sitting at home on the couch watching this on TV. Now I'm sitting here next to Alexei Yagud, and this is a dream.
When he gets those right, they're beautiful. This ending of the program just doesn't hold up. Choreography, it slows down. That was an interesting program, and it was a nice performance. It just, I think he needs to clarify that choreography to bring it to a head, to really give it an ending that is going to sing with it. It kind of falls apart there, and the spins are not good enough. But he has flair. He comes in the tradition of a country that has brought Surya Bonaly and Philippe Candeloro.
Only 18 years of age, Brian Joubert of France.
Now, in this opening move, his quadruple toe, watch him step forward, turn, toe pick, and beautiful revolution. Wonderful position on the landing. That was really first rate. But later, in the middle of the program, he did this triple axel. And watch what happens here. The edge skids before he takes off. He's corkscrew on the landing, and it's a no-no.
Now the marks for Brian Joubert, 5.3 up to 5.7.
And those are very, very high marks. And he had some wonderful jumps in it, but also a lot of mistakes.
Anxiously awaiting the second set of marks. There they are, 5.5 up to 5.8. And Brian Joubert currently in first place, Dick.
Over both Alexander Abt and that's extraordinary.
The youngsters on top.
When we come back, the headliner, Alexei Yagudin. He's been walking gingerly backstage, battling that stress fracture in his hip. He'll take the ice next here in Spokane.
From the smallest beginnings to the biggest events, the United States Figure Skating Association is there for you. We teach America to skate. United States Figure Skating, building America's champions.
Don't forget, next Sunday, don't miss the second stop in the ISU Grand Prix Series of Figure Skating. Among those who will be in Quebec City, Sasha Cohen, Jenny Kirk, and Takeshi Honda, the world bronze medalist. Skate Canada, next Sunday at 4 Eastern, 3 Pacific, on ABC Sports Championship Television. We welcome you back to the men's free skate here at Smart One Skate America, and Alexei Yagudin set to skate, but he has just gone over to the referee to talk this over. Remember, Dickie's got a stress fracture in his hip, and he is going to withdraw, it looks like.
It has. Yep, that's it.
Ladies and gentlemen,
you know, rather than injure yourself, it's a wise move for him to make. It's just a sad moment in a very brilliant career.
Brian Joubert's got to be thinking, are you kidding me?
What happened?
A gold medal? But, you know, this is awfully sad to see. In the press conference after the short program, he really got emotional talking about his injury to the press. He said, I may have to give up competitive skating because this is an injury, an ailment that I've had since birth. It may have gotten worse even if I didn't choose a career as a skater, but now the pounding, the wear and tear, he's got the stress fracture, and who knows what the future holds.
You just hope that we haven't seen Alexei Yagudin skate in his last eligible competition. One skater left, Min Zhang from China, and he's got a shot to win the gold medal when we come back. So far, the man who has stolen the show here in Spokane, the teenager, Brian Joubert from France, only 18 years of age and taking his career to new heights with every performance at Smart One Skate America. He has the lead. Back inside Spokane Arena, the crowd just now settling down after the withdrawal by Alexei Yagudin, the Olympic champ who led after the short program. But here now is Min Zhang in fourth place after the short program. And if he wins the free skate, Dick, remember, without the leader after the short, now you've got Joubert up there. He could win the gold medal in short. Not only win a medal, but he could win the gold. Last year, a fifth and sixth place in the Grand Prix circuit.
Music from the motion pictures Don Juan DeMarco and Robin Hood. Sort of strange to hear that music coming from someone who trains in Beijing, China, lives in Qichihar, China.
Hey, the world is a small place these days.
I know. Very, very nice. Oh, triple axel, triple toe lift. Very, very clean. On this next move, it's a quadruple salchow. Watch and see what he does, if he does what he did in practice. First, get up into the air and then start turning. Not quite as good as I've seen him do. And of course, he turned out of it on the end. quadruple plan here. Quadruple, triple toe. Double freeze at the end of it, and no second jump.
In James, 26 years of age, was actually first discovered when he was in kindergarten, believe it or not, just for his athleticism. Began skating at the age of 6. Moved to Beijing at a young age to live and train. And up until this point, he's really been most known as the guy who did the first quadruple jump in a short program in an ISU event that was right after the rule was put in place back in 99. Been to the World Championships 3 times, had his best finish last year, and came in 9th.
Most of those quadruple jumps and the heavy triple combinations are done right up at the beginning of the program when the skater still has energy. Much more difficult to do it later in the program. Rounded shoulders, completed the jump just fine. But this is a very limited program. It's really kind of steps around the rink into another triple or another move. There's not a lot of creative choreography, or certainly not a character that he's playing, or rounded back there and not a good sit spin position. Again, not a reach back, far one, and it became a double flip. Well, that's kind of an interesting program. Some interesting jumps, some mistakes. Not very good choreography and not very interesting program.
Maybe an opportunity wasted too for Min Zhang from China.
Now the very opening of the program showed this triple axel. Watch him as he steps up into the air. Tight legs, the good landing, very nice. Reaching back perfectly into a triple toe. That was first rate. But shortly thereafter, he attempted this combination, again, a quadruple toe. Watch him reach here. 1, 2, 3, 4 turns. Barely held onto the edge, had to turn 3s and didn't do the second part of the combination.
So Min Zhang, who was in 4th after the short program with a chance to medal, perhaps a silver, maybe a gold, certainly mathematically possible, but after that performance, not sure. But the first set for technical merit, 5.4 to 5.7. Dick, we'll see.
The presentation marks run from 5.3 to 5.6. They're slightly lower. I really think that they should be a lot lower than that.
And the judges' placements, 1 first place from a judge, all the way down to 3 and 4. So Min Zhang ends up in 4th. Guess who? Ryan Joubert, the 18-year-old, and if he were honest right now, he'd say, I'm as shocked as anyone. He wins the gold medal here at Smart One Skate America. So Joubert picks up 12 points with the win. We'll see him again at home in France for Trophy Lalique in a few weeks. Alexander Abt gets 9 points for second place. Matt Savoy, great to see him back on the podium. He picks up 7 points. Michael Weiss ends up in fifth. Dick, let's take a look at our Smart Ones Smart Move replay, the quad toe from Brian Joubert.
And look at as he enters it here, straight body, good clean edges line. Now watch him turn, the three turn, the step back, the toe pick, one, two, three, four, and a very clean landing, just perfect.
Right now, let's check in with Susie Wynn, who is with Alexeya Gudin. Susie?
Thank you, Terry. Alexi, you've come here with a serious injury, but you got through the short program, the practice sessions, and the free program warm-up. What made you decide to withdraw at this time?
Well, actually, I really felt pain a lot in the past week, so I was trying to do everything what could heal the problem, and I even went to the hospital to make the injection. And then, fortunately, it didn't really work as well as it worked for the first time, so I waited till the last second, but I just realized I knew that I can't skate as I have to skate, and it's really sad because that was the first time in my life when I withdraw from the event. I think it was really, I mean, smart for me to do that because, I mean, I couldn't even feel my legs, and this is a takeoff and landing leg, so it was really a lot of pain while I was even just walking. So I guess it's really sad, but that's what I call sport life.
What are you going to do now to take care of your injury?
Well, I just want to see as many doctors as I can and just to get the final opinion what to do and what is exactly happening right now. Just, of course, take some rest and to heal the problem because I guess that's the most important thing in your life.
Mm-hmm. Well, you get some rest and we hope to see you soon.
Thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you. Terry?
All right, Susie, thank you. And we certainly wish Alexeya Gudin all the best, a speedy recovery. We'd love to see him at the World Championships this year. That wraps it up from Spokane. Tomorrow night on ESPN at 9 o'clock Eastern, the short programs from Skate Canada. Next Sunday back on ABC, the men's and ladies free skates from Quebec City. Until then, for our producer, Kurt Gowdy Jr., our director, Doug Wilson, for Susie Wynn, Peggy Fleming, and Dick Button, I'm Terry Gannon. ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com. Keyword, ABC Sports. Goodbye, everybody.